Hello and welcome. You are watching Cricketomania, the show where we discuss everything about cricket. I have with me Ayaz Memon, who knows everything about cricket, and I am Shilpa Ratnam. What we're going to be discussing today is, has India done enough to produce match-winning bowlers? And joining us on the show today is Mr. Kiran More, a former wicketkeeper batsman for the country and also former chairman of the selection committee. Hello, sir.
Hello.
Good to have you on the show.
Thank you.
Right. So to start off with, how have our bowlers been doing in the India-England series right now?
So I think, Shilpa, that's a good start. I think the issue is relevant now in the current context, because we've just played a drawn test match in England. In a sense,
we couldn't get the last two batsmen out.
Last wicket pair made 198 runs.
Wow.
So that apart, our last wicket pair also added 100 plus.
So that's true.
It was that kind of a pitch. But I think the question which arises, and this has been frequent enough, I think Kiran will bear me out, that we've struggled when we get a top order out, we struggle to get the tail out or the lower order out. Why is it so difficult for India to produce match-winning bowlers?
Right.
We've got a bunch of terrific batsmen now.
Right.
We are not so sure whether we've got a bunch of terrific bowlers outside of India.
But haven't batsmen always been our heroes, right? Like Sachin, then you have, every single hero of ours, Dhoni's, mostly batsmen.
You only talk of the current generation. What about Gavaskar and
Vishwanath? What about Kapil Dev? Of course.
No, so more seriously, yes. I think we've been known for our batting more than for our bowling, traditionally, historically.
Hmm.
But we've also had spells when we've had terrific bowlers. Kiran was part of the team in 1986 when we beat England in England.
Right.
And that was because of the bowlers, not so much of the bats, because of the batsmen.
Wow.
So, let me just draw in Kiran into this conversation. Kiran, do you think that we are doing enough to kind of find match-winning bowlers? We need to do something more?
I agree with you totally that last we see the South Africa series or New Zealand series, we were in winning position and we could not win the test match because our bowler could finish the tail. And the biggest setback was New Zealand. Both the time we were in we'll win the test match 2-0. But our bowlers didn't do a good enough job. But after Harbhajan Singh and Anil Kumble, I think we haven't found a single bowler who can win matches for us, overseas especially.
Briefly, Zaheer Khan also, I thought maybe one or two series he looked like a match-winning bowler, like a spearhead, but you're right.
But of course we need a support from the spinners are very important.
Yeah.
And when you're a match with a bowler like Kumble and Harbhajan Singh, those who have taken more than 400 and 600, 700 wickets. And after that, I think that the selectors have not done a good enough job to find a bowler who can win matches for us. And when you look at the statistics of all these bowlers, they're good at domestic, but in India also, in the Indian pitches also, they're good because the wickets are bad, you know, in the third day, fourth day, you know, and when playing on turning tracks, or any bowler, Virat Kohli or somebody else in the Mexican bowler also can get wickets for you. Yeah. But on good wicket, a bowler like Anil Kumble, Harbhajan Singh can get a 5 wickets. Or 6 wickets, or 10 wickets in the match.
Yeah.
But those are the bowlers we're not finding in. And why not we throw a youngster surprise package, you know, like we had already had three bad tours, right?
Yeah.
So on England tour, I was a bit disappointed with the one spinner would have gone on a surprise call and give a surprise to English batsman also. Like Shreyas Gopal, for example, from Karnataka.
Correct, he had a very good season, yes.
Yeah, he had a good season, right? Definitely made a debut.
Yeah.
But when you think about process, if you have gone on this tour, even if you have not played test match, I think you would have been ready for the next tour.
Correct.
You know? But that sort of surprise we have not thrown in. Now, we are still going with Jadeja. We are going with Ashwin. They have proven that they have not done well in overseas.
Yeah.
So why not develop a young bowler or two bowlers, you take them. Give them experience
and
on the tour.
And actually, we've taken 18 players there on that tour.
Yeah. And then you're not taking a match with the bowlers. So you find out a bowler in domestic who is bowling better on the flatter wicket also.
Yeah.
Not only at turning track. What happens in domestic cricket when the selectors watch these matches?
Yeah.
And the spinners comes up, get 45 or 50 wickets or 30 or 70 wickets. But you have to find out what sort of pitches he's playing. He's on the flatter wickets taking wickets. He's bowling better on the flatter wickets. He's not taken wicket. He has taken 20 wickets, but he has bowled outstandingly. You know? But those boys should be picked up.
So Kiran, I've got a couple of questions with permission from Shilpa.
Definitely.
So, you've been part of the Indian team. The questions that I have, and you played for a long time, that is there a particular mindset in Indian cricket which says bowling is too much hard work and therefore forget it, you are batting karte hain? And the other question is that are the pitches in India responsible for bowlers not being produced, or is it basically some flawed administration, or as you mentioned, the selectors not, you know, searching hard enough?
I think what I've thought is like any bowler or any batsman, even when you're used to Indian condition, but when you're prone good, is that when you perform well on overseas tour, if it is a bowler or batter or wicketkeeper, whoever it is, you know,
yeah,
then only you're credible or you become great bowler or great batsman or great, you know, wicketkeeper. Only depend on Indian soil and those guys going to do well. But I feel that the selectors, I thought, could have experimented a lot with the spinners, you know. They could have given opportunity, they could have created a competition also.
Yeah.
That has been not happened, you know. Right. So we need to get a bowler, that's what I said, give a surprise package, you know. I mean, it's not necessary he has taken 100 wickets or 200 wickets, you know.
Yeah.
Right, but Kiran, do you also think that the pitches in India, like you'd asked, about, you know, the flat mostly, aren't they? Whereas in Australia and England, you have these special pitches, you know, bouncy pitches for bowlers to practice
bowlers,
on.
Yeah.
Yeah. So, are pitches in India also responsible for the fact that our bowlers don't have a good training ground to practice on?
I think if you look at the Shilpa, that when you look at the domestic season overall,
right,
there are only a couple of pitches which is very flat.
Right.
But you see, overall, the results in the Ranji Trophy has been very excellent. But that has been, those wickets have been, they're doing too much, you know, like your teams are getting all out 100, 160, 100, 120.
Yeah.
Those are not fair enough pitches, you know. You know, there is actually a one-sided wicket pitches, you know, only for bowlers friendly, totally, there's a lot of grass on the pitch.
Right.
You know, it's not prepared well.
Right.
It should be hard, bouncy pitch like Wankhede. I think Wankhede pitch is one of the best pitches. I've seen the Madhya Pradesh pitch is one of the best pitches in the country.
Right.
You know, so those sort of pitches we produce, you know, I think that really benefits you well, you know.
Yeah.
So I think what happens in most of the pitches which played in some of the states, which is very flatter.
Right.
So there is hardly any scope for the bowler, especially fast bowlers.
So one of the questions, because you mentioned fast bowlers, Kiran, one of the things which is always asked, we talk about it amongst ourselves when we meet, Kiran, is that if we are from the same stock, but Pakistan seems to have an assembly line of fast bowlers, while we struggle to find fast bowlers who are relatively injury-free and can last and play for 7, 8, 10 years. What is the essential difference? Is it in the mindset, or is it in the physical attributes, or what? Or is it the system?
I think it's the mindset, you know. You know, I think if you are a good enough bowler, like I'll give you an example of Bhuneshwar. He's not a quick bowler, but he's one of the best bowlers we have at the moment, you know. And he doesn't have a speed, but he has got a brain. And he bowls in the right area. He swings the ball very well. He knows how to read the pitch also, how to read the batsman also. That's what the other bowlers need to do that. You know, like Jadeja has a great potential, but I don't think he has an excellent brain to use that line and length properly, how to play with the bowler, how to get the wicket, how to buy the wicket. I don't think he has got that. He just keeps and bookkeeps and comes and bowls, you know.
Yeah.
If there is help from the pitch, then he gets wicket, you know. So I think Ashwin is a good thinker. But I think Ashwin need to work more on his test cricket bowling, you know. So I think those are the areas needed to work. You know, that's what we need to find out, the bowler in domestic cricket. If Shreyas Gopal is good, or some Yadav from UP under-19 boy is good, outstanding, he thinks and gets wicket. So give an opportunity for them, you know, and you create those bowlers.
Yeah.
When Harbhajan came into the team, he was under-19 boy, and Ganguly and the selectors had guts to pick him. You know,
yeah,
and create an opportunity for him. And that's today, Harbhajan has taken more than 450 wickets.
And speaking of creating opportunities, Stuart Binney might get his debut at...
He made his debut at Trent Bridge.
Right.
So whether he's going to be retained for Lords or not, I think he should be after the innings he's played. But he's not your main bowler. You know, he's not the frontline bowler. He's the
Definitely.
Third or fourth option as a bowler. He's probably the all-rounder that India is looking for. But, you know, you mentioned about fast bowlers. Kiran, Umesh Yadav is playing for the India A team. He's not part of the Indian team in England. He's in Australia. He's doing extremely well with bat and ball. Now, he's, I think, your quickest bowler in the country who's not found a place on the tour to England. Do you find that a little odd or do you agree with the selection?
When the seven bowlers have gone on England tour, so for me, it was a surprise package. You know, all the other guys have got opportunity. And Umesh Yadav, who was there on New Zealand tour or South African tour of the that in 15, and suddenly doesn't find a place on England tour. And he's a guy who has got more experience also.
Yeah.
And he's one of the quickest fast bowlers we have. And he doesn't find a place in England tour. So I was very surprised, you know. And then he should have been there in the team. That's what I felt, you know. But the selectors call all the time what they're thinking is. And when you played a first test match, and when you're talking about all-rounder, even Ashwin has scored 200 in a test cricket.
Correct.
So I think, I don't know what is the thinking going on behind. I think if Ashwin would have played, definitely would have taken 3-4 wickets. So that would have been the major, you know, contribution to the team.
Yeah.
So this does seem to be a tough question to answer. But let's see what the people on the street think about this conundrum. Are we doing enough to get match-winning players in India?
Match-winning ballers, तो हमारे पास ऐसा कुछ है ही नहीं. और efforts तो है ऐसा. हमारे पास अच्छे-अच्छे pace academies है बहुत. But वहाँ से कुछ आ नहीं रहा हमारे पास. Efforts हो रहा है, but ऐसा एकदम जैसे पाकिस्तान में जैसे ballers हैं, हमारे पास वैसा potential है ही नहीं. आते हैं वो थोड़ा टाइम के लिए आते हैं, बस वो इनिशियली आएगा थोड़ा टाइम के लिए, अच्छा पेस डालेगा 140s में आएगा, फिर बाद में वो इंजरी हो जाता है, जो होता है, मतलब कुछ इतना कुछ आगे कुछ होता नहीं है. इनिशियली थोड़ा डेवलप होता है बस, उसके बाद में थोड़ा फेम भी हो जाता है, फिर वो 120s 30s में आ जाता है फिर से वो.
फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल व्हाट आई थिंक इज द पिचेस इन इंडिया आर नॉट मच बॉलर फ्रेंडली लाइक and another thing which I feel is that we have many good bowlers like Munaf Patel and Srishant who are very fast paced initially when they come to international cricket, but when later on after one or two years that doesn't give much importance to fitness and the pace is less. Like Srishant has now he's not playing in the cricket, but Munaf Patel has pace like something 120 or 130. Initially when he came to international cricket he has pace like approximately 150 kilometers. So that's whereas we look in international cricket, international cricketers like Mitchell Johnson, they are playing for last 10 years, 5 years, but their pace is still maintained like 150s, 140s. We have players like Bradley who is a legend and still his pace is like 150, and we don't have not even a single bowler who can touch 150 mark now. We are lacking the pace, that's why I think we are not doing so good in test cricket, whereas in one day it's okay.
Actually, abhi tak to kuch tha hi nahi. जो लेकिन अब जाके कुछ तो लोग है कि जो अभी डेवलप हो रहे हैं, जो बॉलिंग साइड भी अच्छी अपनी होती जा रही है. जैसे आज तक हमने देखा था कि बाहर जाके ओवरसीज जाके अच्छे परफॉर्म नहीं करते, लेकिन अभी जो फर्स्ट टेस्ट मैच हम लोग ने देखा तो उसमें अच्छा खासा उन लोग ने परफॉर्म किया है बॉलर्स लोग ने. फिर भी जो फास्ट जो स्पीड वगैरह है ऐसे आज तक के वो कोई अचीव नहीं करा कि बाबा कि हम लोग को 150 160 वगैरह अचीव करना है, तो वैसे नहीं हो रहा है और वो होना चाहिए. उसके लिए वैसे वो एज अ देखेंगे तो हम लोग बैट्समैन के हिसाब से हम लोग यहाँ पे सब पिचेस वगैरह बनाए जाते हैं जो फास्ट बॉलिंग के हिसाब से नहीं होता है.
नो आई थिंक यू नीड बेटर पिचेस इन एट द ग्रास रूट लेवल. यू नीड बेटर पिचेस सो दैट मोर फास्ट बॉलर्स आर एनकरेज्ड टू बोल फास्ट रादर देन कीप सेविंग देयर पेस फॉर द लेटर स्टेजेस. एंड आई डोंट थिंक द क्लाइमेटिक कंडीशंस आर आल्सो गुड इनफ फॉर फास्ट बॉलिंग.
My answer will be average because if you see the bowlers or any players, it's not just the bowlers, it's even the batsmen. They earn enough from acting in advertisements and everything. You know, sometimes they lack practice or something like that.
सबसे बड़ा reason तो वही है कि सबको सचिन बनना है, सबको विराट कोहली बनना है. बॉलिंग साइड किसी को नहीं चाहिए. और वैसे भी आप उन्हें पास देखते आए तो गावस्कर, उसके बाद सचिन, सब लोग बैटिंग जो भी हो यहाँ पे हो या ओवरसीज हो सब बैटिंग पे अपना कॉन्सेंट्रेट करते हैं. और लास्ट फास्ट बोला तो याद भी नहीं, जहीर खान के बाद कौन होगा. पर फर्स्ट हाँ एक्चुअली फर्स्ट टेस्ट में किया बॉलर्स ने अच्छा, शुड बी बेटर हो सकता था. और ज्यादा करके इंडिया में स्पिनर्स भी बहुत होते हैं तो स्पिन अटैक पे भी ज्यादा ध्यान देते.
इतना मैं बोल नहीं सकता कि परफेक्ट है मैच विनिंग बॉलर,
लेकिन अभी अभी मैंने एक दो तीन परफॉर्मेंस देखे है, तो अब पीछे का बांग्लादेश दौरा जो हो गया, हमने टारगेट रखा था 50 ओवर में 105, ये काफी ये आसान था बांग्लादेश के लिए, लेकिन 58 पे ऑल आउट किया और स्टुअर्ट बिंदी ने 6 विकेट ले लिया। हम देखते हैं कि जो नया बॉलर आता है उनका स्टार्टिंग का परफॉर्मेंस अच्छा रहता है, जैसे कि ईशांत शर्मा हो गया, आरपी सिंह हो गया, लेकिन बाद में उनको क्या हो जाता है मुझे मालूम नहीं। अभी तो मुझे लगता है कि ऐसा कोई बॉलर नहीं है कि जो मैच टर्न कर सकता है, टेस्ट के लिए बता रहा हूँ मैं, वनडे में है तोड़बिंदी ने अच्छा परफॉर्मेंस दिया, लेकिन टेस्ट के लिए कोई ऐसा अच्छा बॉलर नहीं है कि जो मैच विनिंग परफॉर्मेंस दे सकता है।
Everyone wants to grow up and become either Sachin or Virat.
Right? Yeah, the batsman. What you're saying is, are batsmen being idolized? Let's ask Kiran that. Is it that batsmen get idolized in India, bowlers don't, and therefore everybody, youngsters' tendency is to, you know, try and be a batsman rather than a bowler? Unlike say, in Pakistan, where people want to be an Imran Khan or a Wasim Akram.
I think fast bowling is a hard work.
Yeah.
Of course, batting is not that easy, but fast bowling is very hard work. And tell you the fact that people talking about the speed, I don't agree there. We don't need the fast bowlers who need to have speed, you know. Yeah. We need a one bowler who can bowl quick, you know, but in the spells. But we need a smart bowlers who can swing the ball, read the pitch well, and bowl according to the situation of the match, you know, and get the batsman out, you know, work on his weaknesses, you know. Like, as an example, Anderson is such a successful bowler. Even Chamunda was the second 400 wickets in Test cricket.
Yeah.
So they were very smart bowlers. They used to bowl, swing ball well, and keep on bowling all the time at the batsman with the wrong, weak areas, and get wickets, you know. And Anderson today also, he's depending on the swing and line and length.
And he's a terrific bowler.
He's a terrific bowler. So and he's like, that's why Bhuneshwar Kumar is very successful. He's a very smart bowler. He knows how to swing the ball. He bowl which area he needs to bowl.
Yeah.
And that's what Bhuneshwar Kumar does. So and Kiran, we need bowlers like Bhuneshwar Kumar to take the team.
Quick question to you. You played for so long for India and in first-class cricket, and you're a keen student of cricket and a keen observer of Indian cricket. What do you think that needs to be done where India has a regular supply of quality bowlers who can, you know, go out and win matches overseas? In India, our record is terrific. We seem to win almost everything that is played in India, but almost nothing when we play overseas. So it's a, you know, this gap, how does one fill?
I think the India A tours are very important.
Yeah.
We need to have continuation of the India A tours. We should not have a huge gap. There should be every time the India A tour has to Sri Lanka or South Africa, Australia, New Zealand, wherever they go, you know, that's very important to that. And again, you just in the National Cricket Academy, you focus on the quality players, quality bowlers, you know. So we have backup players all the time, you know, but that is not happening, you know. I think there are so many changes in National Cricket Academy also. And plus, as I want to say that here, that state association has to be strong. And if your state association is strong, if you have 10 good teams in the national tournament, I think you are very successful because you're going to get good cricketers, good cricket, and definitely you'll produce some quality cricketers in bowling and the bowling and wicket keeping. That is not happening. And when you see there are 3 to 4 teams, which is always doing very well, they are in part of the finals and the semifinals, and that's the couple of teams which have become champions in the national tournaments.
Right. So some important questions answered there, but now we have to see whether people were able to answer the questions that we threw at them. Let's take a look.
बस उसके अलावा कोई नहीं.
कपिल देव थे.
श्रीनाथ, I think at his peak was very fast.
I really don't know. I'm not aware of it.
कपिल देव.
कपिल देव.
हाँ कपिल देव.
अनिल कुंबले.
अनिल कुंबले ने ले लिया.
अनिल कुंबले.
अनिल कुंबले.
अनिल कुंबले.
अनिल कुंबले.
अनिल कुंबले.
पाकिस्तान से.
Was it Pakistan?
Maybe Zimbabwe,
Sri Lanka.
Maybe all this.
Questions about batsmen are answered much better, I think.
That shows you the priorities of the Indian fan. But you know, I mean, look, we've got such a glorious and strong tradition of batting heroes,
right
from the days of Vijay Merchant, and you know, through Gavaskar and Tendulkar and Dravid. So So you can't blame fans, and you know, as Kiran said, that bowling is a lot of hard work, especially fast bowling, so everybody is not inclined in India. And it's also the subcontinent, you know, the kind of climate we have in most parts of the country.
Right.
It gets extremely hot and muggy and sweaty, and people don't want to
bowl. So Pakistan, you think, has an edge there?
Pakistan is more north.
Exactly.
You know,
yeah.
There's no Pakistan down south.
Yeah. Fair enough. That's what
yeah,
I meant.
Yeah. So they've, and you know, also genetically, I think it makes a bit of a
Pathan.
Difference. Yeah. So, but Kiran, the absolute last question to you, do you see potential? We've got 6 fast bowlers on this tour of England. Do you see match winning potential in this, you know, these number of bowlers? Do you think we can win this current series?
I feel that only Pankaj Singh is looking very good, you know, solid.
You know, and I absolutely share this opinion with you. I think he should be played sooner rather than later.
Yeah, he's looking very solid, you know, and definitely Ishan comes into spells and bowls here and there and does a couple of wickets he got this time. I think he looked the best. But he could have completed. He wants to become a top bowler in the world cricket or in Indian cricket history. He needs to finish the match. And that's what he's not doing. Every time you talk about New Zealand, you talk about South Africa, yeah. He has not finished the tail at all. So when you're a quality bowler, you're playing for the country where you've played 50 test matches and you cannot take last 2 wickets, so I think there is a question mark as a player, because when you select a team, you select a team as a all match winners. You just can't pick a boy in the team that, okay, he's just a support player and he can do bits and pieces. No. You pick a 11 which is a match winner. So that's how you win the match.
Well, I hope our 11 are going to be a match winning 11. Thank you so much for joining us, Mr. Kiran. And thank you so much for your views. Otherwise, you would have had a tough day discussing that just today.
Thanks,
<you?
laughs> Kiran. Thanks for being with us.
All right. Before we leave you, however, we have the question of the day thrown to you by Mr. Ayaz Memon. Take it away, Ayaz.
Well, I think you asked most of the questions there. But I want to know the name of a bowler who took 16 wickets on test debut. First test match, an Indian bowler playing. 16 wickets. Who is that bowler?
Okay, I'm going to quickly go and look that up, and if you're faster than me, you can win this exclusive Flipkart voucher that we have with your name on it. Alright, thank you so much for joining us, and do remember to keep tuning in to Cricketomania.